Are you confused about probiotics and prebiotics? If so, you're not alone. My name is Karen Graham. I am a registered dietitian and a certified diabetes educator. Watch this video to learn which foods are great sources of probiotics and prebiotics. Every day, we are learning about how important these gut bacteria are to help us digest food and how they work together to keep us healthy. As I go through the food sources of probiotics and prebiotics, keep in mind, you don't need to eat all these foods. Think about making a small change. Start off by adding into your diet one new probiotic food. For example, start with a small glass of buttermilk. And one new prebiotic food, such as leeks, which are wonderful in soup. Fermented probiotic foods, such as olives, sauerkraut, or kimchi, are great sources of healthy bacteria. But keep in mind that the fermentation process involves adding salt, so these fermented foods are high in sodium. If you have high blood pressure or chronic kidney disease, you'll need to choose these fermented salty foods less and in careful moderation. If you have a health condition, always talk to your doctor or dietitian about individualized advice. So, without further delay, we'll now look at a variety of probiotic and prebiotic foods.
Probiotics are gut bacteria. There are hundreds of different kinds of probiotic bacteria that live in your large intestine and digest food. These good bacteria work together to keep you healthy. They are found in yogurt and other fermented foods. Let's take a closer look at some great probiotic foods. First, we've got fermented milks and cheeses. Yogurt, buttermilk, kefir, and sour cream. And some cheeses such as parmesan, cheddar, gouda, Swiss, and cottage cheese. Other fermented foods include sourdough bread, Worcestershire sauce and soy sauce, sauerkraut, kimchi, olives, and pickles. Most of these foods have strong or sour flavors, and because they're high in salt, have them in small amounts only. Prebiotics are foods that contain soluble fiber. Soluble fiber is the food that the probiotic bacteria like to eat. It allows the good bacteria to grow and multiply in your gut. Let's take a closer look now at some great prebiotic foods. Raw fruits and vegetables, such as apples, pears, grapefruits, or bananas, and vegetables like carrots. And beans and lentils are a great source of prebiotics, such as black beans, chickpeas, split peas, kidney beans, and navy beans. For those of you that have my three books co-authored with Dr. Shamali, you'll see how I've included probiotic and prebiotic foods in small amounts as part of the different meals and snacks. So for example, in Diabetes Essentials, the brownies includes canned lentils. What a fun way to include your prebiotic. In the Complete Diabetes Guide, in lunch number 2, we have the taco soup, which includes black beans and kidney beans. And an example from the cookbook is dinner number 15, which is pierogies, that includes sauerkraut in the meal. And here's a photograph of the meal, the pierogi meal with the sauerkraut as part of the meal.